other thing is Gopashtami. Gopashtami. So now, you see, the Krishna's age is divided into four. From birth to five, it's called Kumara Avastha. And from 6 to 10 is Pauganda. And from 11 to 15 is Kishora. And above 16 is Yauvana, you know, Nava Yauvana, Yuvakam. So when he was around 6 years old, you know, suddenly one fine day, Krishna is telling Mother Yashoda, looks like I'm getting elder. So, you know, I need to take up the responsibilities of my father. So, till now, Krishna was taking the calves for grazing. So he says, now I want to take the cows because I'm getting elder. So the mother is like, no, you're not elder yet. You're very young. And these cows have big horns. And these cows, sometimes they just go away deep inside the forest, you know, and I can't send you. It's not very safe. So then Krishna has a tough argument with mother. And he's like, no, look, I am the one and the only son of of Nanda Maharaj, the king of Raja. And as a obedient, sincere, faithful son, I want to take up the responsibilities of my father as soon as possible, and I want to relieve him. So kindly allow me, I will take the cows henceforth for grazing. So while both of them are arguing like this, and Krishna is like, look, mother, so you don't want me to take over after father? And she says, yeah, but, and then she doesn't know what excuses to make. So she's like, yeah, but you see, when the father's business is taken over by the son, you just don't do it overnight. You have to have a proper muhurta, you know, auspicious timings you do that. So while they're speaking like this, you know, by Krishna's divine arrangement, Gargamuni walks in. And then as soon as Gargamuni walks in, Krishna is so happy. And it's like, look, mother, you can ask him for an auspicious time. So then, you know, Gargamuni, he wants to please the Lord. So he immediately looks here and there and he's like, okay, tomorrow morning seems to be very auspicious time for Krishna to take over. And Krishna is like, look, I told you, so let me go from tomorrow morning. And then mother is finally convinced and she says, that's all right, but at least let me stitch a nice footwear for you because there will be lots of thorns in the forest. And Krishna is like, no, mother, you are getting it all wrong. We are the servants of the cows. Cows are the masters. And if the masters don't have the footwear, how can I have a footwear? So do one thing. If you want me to wear the footwear, then make sure you have footwear for all the cows. Now the cows are 9 lakhs and then they have 4 legs. So 9 fours are 36 lakhs. So Yashoda Mata is like, I can't. And then he's like, okay, if you can't, then even I'm not wearing them. So while this conversation is going on, the cows in the Goshala of Nanda Maharaj, they're hearing this, you know, they're looking through and they're hearing this from the windows. And when they hear that, they cry, you know, Krishna loves us so much. So what they do is in the middle of the night, they just go all over, right from Nanda Maharaj house to the places where they graze. They just go and stamp and stamp and stamp and make sure that they make the sand very, very soft so that next day morning when Krishna goes with them, nothing should hurt Krishna. So in the morning when they see, there's just no stones, no pebbles left. Everything is very soft like a velvet. Even now when we go to Vrindavan, in few places, most of them they're made into tar roads, but you go to places like Ramanreti, and then you go in, sometimes when you're doing the Giriraj Parikrama, if you go inside the inner route, you know, you can still find that the sand is so soft and very much like a velvet. And I don't think anywhere in the world we see this kind of a very smooth texture of the soil, you know, the sand there. So then this is what happens, and Mother Yashoda finally agrees, and the next day morning Krishna is up early and he's all dressed to go. And now Radharani, when she comes to know that, she also wants to take Krishna's association. So she takes advantage of this thing and she dresses herself like a cowherd boy, because Radharani was having a resemblance to Subal Sakha. So then she dresses like Subal Sakha and she wears the dhoti and kurta, and then she joins Krishna with her friends as he goes for grazing the cows for the very first time. So this particular leela happens in the month of Kartik, that is the Gopashtami. So even now in temples around the world, in ISKCON and in Vrindavan, you will see on Gopashtami day, they dress Radharani like a boy with a dhoti. And then you can also see the lotus feet of Radharani, which are otherwise not visible. So this Leela.
Sab Krishna, Krishna, Krishna lage. Sab Krishna, Krishna, Krishna lage. Sab Krishna.